The Bexar County DA's office supports giving a local opioid task force the green light to pursue a needle exchange program.
Almost 100 Americans die every single day from opioid overdose in every community across this nation.
President Donald Trump's campaign boss wants to bring the 2020 GOP convention home to San Antonio.
Brad Parscale previously headed the digital operations for the 2016 presidential campaign. The president's son, Eric Trump, called Parscale pivotal to our success in 2016.
And Governor Greg Abbott demands former Representative Blake Farenthold cover the costs of an emergency special election caused by his abrupt resignation.
In a December video on his campaign's Facebook page, Farenthold denied accusations of harassment by a former aide who was fired, but he also apologized for an office atmosphere that was less than professional.
I'm Chance Dorland with your Express Briefing for Thursday, April 26th. Subscribe to this and other free content at expressnews.com/podcasts and get each day's top news and sports headlines delivered to your inbox at expressnews.com/newsletters. For years, Bexar County officials have attempted to institute some form of a syringe exchange program aimed at reducing the spread of infectious diseases and encouraging addicts to seek treatment. And while opposition to pilot programs and legislation have foiled and ultimately stalled needle exchange plans in recent years, now District Attorney Nico LaHood, along with the Democratic and Republican nominees vying to succeed him in office, all support some form of an exchange program, and due in part to a 2008 opinion from then-Attorney General Greg Abbott, district attorneys have the final say on whether to charge program workers with possession or distribution of drug paraphernalia. The idea of a needle exchange program is in its earliest stages, and it remains unclear whether the initiative would begin before LaHood leaves office, at a time when Texas remains the only state that has not legalized syringe exchange. Support from both the current and future Bexar County District Attorney reflects what some see as a growing acceptance of needle exchange to stop the spread of diseases like HIV and hepatitis C, which are passed through dirty needles. A 2000 study also found that people who used a needle exchange program in Seattle were 5 times more likely to enter drug treatment than those who had never used the program, part of the reason the task force views it as an option to address opioid use. The AP's Jennifer King has more.
Opioid overdoses killed more than 1,300 Americans ages 65 and older in 2016. About 300,000 Medicare patients have been diagnosed with opioid addiction. As America deals with the opioid crisis, legislators are considering allowing Medicare to cover methadone treatment. Part of the problem is that methadone can't be dispensed in a retail pharmacy. Patients are assessed by a doctor, then show up daily at a federally certified methadone clinic to take their dose of the pink liquid. The clinics now have about 25,000 Medicare beneficiaries, most of whom are paying out of pocket about $80 a week or getting care through state-run Medicaid or block grant programs. Mark Perino, who's the president of the American Association for the Treatment of Opioid Dependence, thinks more people would seek methadone treatment if Medicare covered it.
President Donald Trump campaign manager Brad Parscale wants San Antonio to host the 2020 Republican National Convention, taking to social media to voice his frustration at the city's lack of a response to bid for the event. In an email to Mayor Ron Nirenberg on Wednesday, Parscale pressed for a response, saying that while, quote, many cities are killing to have this, that it was very important he let the group in D.C. know that San Antonio was going to pass on the opportunity. Parscale then used his Twitter account to express further frustration, writing, quote, coming soon to San Antonio. Another mayor makes an epic political mistake that takes a possible $200 million from the community. Why? Maybe he is just waiting on Mayor Scully to decide for him, referring to city manager Cheryl Scully. While Nirenberg says he does not respond to political operatives' tweet storms, former Mayor Julian Castro, who has said he might run for the Democrats' presidential nomination in 2020, did respond, tweeting, quote, the Trump campaign is so scared of losing Texas in 2020 that it is desperately trying to get San Antonio to bid for the RNC convention as political insurance. It won't work, Brad. RNC loses millions for its hosts, and you're going to lose Texas anyway in 2020. Mayor Nirenberg has invited council members to a closed-door discussion next week about whether the city should attempt a late bid to host the event, which could be an economic bonanza for San Antonio. Parscale ran the Trump campaign's successful digital operation from San Antonio 2 years ago, and in addition to directing the president's political operation, now sits on the 12-member committee that chooses the convention site. And in a rare move, Wednesday, Governor Greg Abbott demanded scandal-plagued former Representative Blake Farenthold cover the costs of the upcoming emergency special election that has been called in the wake of his abrupt resignation earlier this month. Abbott's payment demand came a day after he decreed an expedited special election on June 30th, using emergency powers to bypass state and federal laws that he said could have pushed back voting into September. In a letter to Farenthold's former congressional office, Abbott also urged the Corpus Christi Republican to make good on the $84,000 he promised to repay the U.S. Treasury for a taxpayer-funded settlement he reached in a 2014 sexual harassment lawsuit. Abbott wants Farenthold to respond by next Wednesday, but with no legal requirement for Farenthold to pay or even respond to the governor, political analysts say the demand could amount to little more than a gesture for the Republican governor to put pressure on the ex-congressman and distance himself from the scandal. Local election officials estimate the costs of the special election will be more than $200,000 to be borne by the 13 counties that compose the district along the Texas Gulf Coast. And that's your daily San Antonio Express News Briefing for Thursday, April 26th. Subscribe to this and other free content at expressnews.com/podcasts. I'm Chance Dorland.